media preview for the New York Auto Show takes place over 2 full days. And in that time, we've seen performance vehicles, SUVs, crossovers, and even a few concepts. So here's a look at some of the highlights of the 2009 New York Auto Show. Here in New York, there were a couple of interesting crossovers that made their debut. One of them is the BMW X6M. It's basically a high-performance version of the X6 they recently introduced. There's also the Acura ZDX. It's sort of a more odd-looking car, but its intent is to combine the best of sports sedan, sports cars, and sport utilities into one package. We'll see if it's successful or not when the car goes on sale in the fall of this year. In terms of SUVs making their debut here in New York, of course, there's the all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee. It combines luxury with excellent off-road performance. At the opposite end of the spectrum is the GMC Terrain. It's front-wheel drive and more fuel-efficient. It probably does its best work on the road. When it comes to performance cars here in New York, you've got to mention the E63 AMG. Of course, it's based on the all-new E-Class, but it gets a lot of performance-enhancing upgrades, like this hand-built 518-horsepower V8 engine. At this year's New York Auto Show, there's a lot of new cars, but not many concepts. One exception is this Scion IQ concept, and although it's not headed for production, the intent is to gauge interest to see if Scion might sell a car just like this one here in the US. By far the most radical concept here in New York is this Hyundai Nuvis. Now, this is never going to be a production vehicle, but some of the design cues may show up on the next Hyundai Santa Fe. It's day two of the media preview here at the 2009 New York Auto Show, and both Japanese and Korean automakers have made fairly strong showings. First with the Subaru Legacy and Subaru Outback. Both cars are larger, but the Outback especially should have more off-road ability. There's also the Kia Forte Coupe, a car that starts well under $20,000, but has more horsepower than a Honda Civic. There's also the Mitsubishi Outlander GT prototype, and although it isn't a production car, it hints very strongly at what that 2010 Outlander will look like. Here on the second day of the 2009 New York Auto Show, Kia made a fairly strong showing with the all-new Forte Coupe. Now, we've already seen the sedan, but the coupe is pretty sharp looking, and it only comes in 2 trim levels. There's no base model because it's supposed to be a little more sporty, a little more upscale. So there's no one real wow car here in New York, but there have been several models that are significant. And the great thing about most of these cars is that they should be hitting showroom floors at about the same time most experts predict a positive change in the economy.